I think he's one of the most prolific and important artists of the 20th century. He did a bit of everything. You may not like it all, but he sure did it all.
He had this mystical, intuitive understanding of things and saw the Taos Valley and had immediate epiphany. Dennis came in and bought the Mabel Dodge house. We moved the film editors and their families, and I was the associate producer, and I moved in with my family, and we created an editing facility in the house, and then we bought the El Cortez Theatre.
And Dennis used this as his studio, and friends would stay here when they come through town. Also, I think he may have been on the run from the law just a little bit in LA.
It was amazing how exciting it was to be with him. That it was like being attached to an adrenaline pump. Oh, wow, man, look at that. You know, and he would bring the magic out of the most mundane situations. His work is unique.
I got the keys to the place, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna start going through this stuff. Everybody's telling me, just get a dumpster, throw it all out. Couldn't, I had to look at everything. I pulled out a pair of socks, old box of macaroni, letter from Miles Davis. And then I knew I had to look at every scrap of paper and piece of macaroni just to be sure it wasn't something.
Any extra money he ever had, he spent on art. Dennis and Book's place was just totally destroyed and he lost everything. He lost all those paintings. I have the only one that survived because before the fire, he gave me this one little painting.
There were a lot of surprises when I was going through things. There were some pretty racy pictures with a lot of skin that probably would wind up with a paper wrapper over them. The moviola that he edited the last movie on still had the film catching bin in the front of it. And I was digging through it, going and trying to look at it. I pull this piece out and it's Chris Christopherson, me and Bobby McGee, still in the bin. The script from the Johnny Cash show was great. I think that's one of Dennis's best performances. But when we began to go through the books, flip through them, give them all a shake. So I'd probably given a shake to every one of those books 10 times. But once we finished cataloging everything, my partner in this debacle decides to go through them one last time. And they gave it a shake and it got past us four or five times. It was just hanging on wherever it was at. So that was a real surprise.
In 1985, he was straight and sober. And in 25 years until his death, he made 87 movies, directed 6, 78 TV shows, worked all the time. But when he wasn't working, he'd drop in here